Hey there, friend! Today we are going to use some math tools we already know to practice something new. We are going to use number bonds and number sentences to compose and decompose numbers. Before we get started, let's find out what these big new words mean. Like I said, today we are going to practice composing and decomposing numbers. Composing means to put together smaller numbers to make a bigger number. Decomposing means to break apart a bigger number into smaller numbers. So really, we are going to practice making and breaking numbers today. Let's look at this number bond. We have two parts, but no whole. That means we have to compose or put together smaller numbers to make a bigger number, the whole. Did you know we can use addition to compose numbers? When we write addition sentences, we always add together our parts to find the whole. So, 3 plus 1 equals. I'm going to use my fingers to find the answer. I have 1, 2, 3 plus 1 more equals 1, 2, 3, 4. Our whole is 4. Addition sentences follow a pattern. Part plus part equals whole. We can use addition to compose numbers. Let's take a look at a new problem. Whoa! Look at this number bond! We have the whole and only one part. If addition sentences are part plus part equals whole, how can we solve this problem when we're only given one part? To find our answer, we will need to use subtraction to decompose or break apart the whole. Let me show you what I mean. We know our whole is 3 and one part is 2. When we subtract, we always start with the whole, which is the bigger number. So that means 3 comes first. Now, the only other number we have here is one of the parts, 2. To find the other part, we need to take away 2 from 3. 3 minus 2 equals. Let's use a strategy to find our answer. I can build a tower of 1, 2, 3 snap cubes. Then how many will I take away? 2. 1, 2. Now how many do I have left? 1. The missing part is 1. We can use subtraction to help us decompose numbers. Subtraction sentences always follow a pattern. Whole minus part equals part. Amazing! We just composed a number using addition to help us find the missing whole and decomposed a number using subtraction to help us find the missing part. Now, let's look at another number bond and decide whether we need to compose or decompose in order to find what's missing. Here we have the number bond with two parts and no whole. To find the whole, are we going to use addition or subtraction? Addition! So our number sentence will be part plus part equals whole, or 4 plus 1 equals. Let's draw a quick picture to find the answer. I have 1, 2, 3, 4 in this part, and only 1 in this part. Now let's count them all together to find the answer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4 plus 1 equals 5. Great job! Now, what would we need to do if one of the parts disappeared from the number bond? Would we use addition or subtraction to find the missing part? Subtraction! Our subtraction sentence will be in this order. Whole minus part equals the other part. So, 5 minus 4 equals 1. Good job! Today we practiced a new skill called composing and decomposing numbers. Those are big words, but it just means to make and break numbers. And we can use tools we already know, like number bonds, addition, and subtraction to help us compose and decompose numbers. Remember, in math, we can solve any problem together. You can count on it. See you next time! Hey.